We speak now to Arts and Culture Minister Nathi Mthethwa, joining us on the line. Minister Mthethwa, your reflections on Jonas Gwangwa, on his legacy, on what South Africa has lost today.
South Africa has lost a maestro today, a world giant who's been known over 40 years of his service and sharing with the nation, his craft, and he will be remembered by showing the potency of arts and culture across the world, even when the ANC gave him the task of being part and parcel of the Amandla Ensemble. And one of the things he kept on emphasizing was the unity of our people, because if you look at the makeup of Amandla, it was drawn across the ethnic groups in the country here, and collaborating in sharing the culture of our people.
Yeah.
He put South Africa on the map, on the our own South African genre of jazz, which was unique in the world, and they took the world by storm. To this day, people remember the likes of Jonas Gwangwa's work, Hugh Masekela, Mamire Makeba, and others.
Minister, are you able to explain how important was Amandla? A lot of people have mentioned he was the leader of that, this cultural pushback against apartheid. How influential were the arts at that time?
Well, it showed, as I said, the power of this soft power, which is art. And it was in line, and it epitomized what the ANC stands for, and that is the unity of our people. It drew people and it conscientized all the African people to other different cultures, as it were, and embrace them, so that as African people fighting an evil system of apartheid, unity amongst us was always important. So there was no way better than arts and culture to make the point. That is why Amandla is so popular around the world, whether we are going to Europe, whether we are in Americas or Asia. You will find people even today still have those old vinyl records of Amandla, because they understood the message of Amandla itself.
Minister, can you respond to what our earlier guest said, Gabby LaRue from the Trade Union for Musicians of South Africa, saying government could do much more. Somehow we should harness the influence, the legacy of the Jonas Gwangwas and the other giants of South African jazz, and looking at the anti-apartheid legacy and really using it to encourage and inspire young people. How could that be done?
Well, KB is correct. It's very correct. You would recall that we launched the Living Legends Legacy Fraternity. The primary task of this organization is precisely that, to harness this heritage, to celebrate these living legends whilst they are still alive, but also to run masterclasses so that the intergenerational mix is realized, particularly the collaboration between the older and younger generation. And that project started. We have seen it going. At some point, it slowed down. With the revival of the Living Legends Legacy Fraternity under the leadership of Dr. John Gani, that particular project will go ahead, because that's precisely why we have the LLF. Mm.
Minister, before we let you go, this is also an opportunity for you to pay your tribute to another fallen hero, many would say, in the political world, well-respected, well-loved minister in the presidency, Jackson Mthembu, who left us earlier this week. And of course, there's a whole program of events that we've been following. Has his life been celebrated in these recent days? And of course, amidst all the sadness as well.
In politics, you rarely find an individual who will be embraced by all, opponents, friends, and everybody. And there's a reason for that, because Minister Mthembu was a people's person. He was somebody who was a friend to everybody. In fact, he would call everybody Mganwami. And he meant that. He was a true leader who believed in the values of hard work, of dedication to service and serving the people. And because of those very values of him, he never enjoyed his youth. Right from that time, he dedicated himself and devoted his whole in the struggle, from the student politics to youth politics, growing up in the movement. So it's somebody who symbolizes and epitomizes what you call selflessness in service of the people. Mm.
All right, thank you for those tributes tonight, remembering Jackson Mthembu, remembering Jonas Gwangwa, that was Minister of Arts and Culture, Nathi Mthethwa.